Hey everyone, it's Justin again, and thank you so much for joining us today. Whenever you watch a TV show or a movie, it's nice to just sit back and enjoy the show, right? Well, today we're going to be meeting some of the people who work behind the scenes to make everything happen. Let's take a news program, for example. Something occurs that makes the news, and within just a few hours, boom, it's on your screen. The story, the people, the setting, and any other relevant information. So, who puts it all together? What kinds of jobs are there in the fast-paced world of television news and other kinds of broadcasting, for that matter? Well, today we're going to be meeting someone who helps bring you the news. Larry Goldfine is a video editor who takes all the elements that make up a news story and puts it together into what you see on screen. So stay tuned as Larry takes us behind the scenes of the TV newsroom and teaches us what it takes to be a video editor. Larry Goldfine is an editor for the CBS Evening News with Nora O'Donnell.
My job is editing videotape for the CBS Evening News. And a typical day for me would be, I come in the morning, I find out my assignment, and I start gathering material, which is like video that was shot by our field crews, or it could have been shot by our affiliate stations. As the day goes by, I start getting scripts from the producer or the correspondent who's out in the field. The scripts are my way of laying everything out. So I start laying out all of the video that I'm using, all of the sound. I start moving this here, moving that here. And then eventually it comes up to a cut that I can then share with everybody.
So Larry takes these elements and then puts them together in a way that will tell the best story on the air. When you're working with breaking news, you're dealing with a very tight deadline. You've got to make rapid decisions and create the story quickly. Imagine that you turn on the TV, ready to watch the news, and then an announcer just says, "Oh, sorry, we're not ready yet."
Something suddenly doesn't work right, or you find that they change a line at the last minute and you're about to go on the air. I mean, we always say that we have a deadline that is unbreakable. You know, if you're a lawyer, and you can't meet the deadline, you could push the deadline ahead. But if you're an editor in television or a producer, you have a deadline. You cannot miss it. You cannot miss it.
Wow, that sounds stressful. It's clear that to be a video editor, you're going to need some time management skills. And actually, we've got some helpful tips on how to handle stressful situations and build time management skills in the PDF for this lesson.
So what I do first is make sure that I have something laid out from beginning to end, all covered. It may not be perfect, but it's laid out. So if worse comes to worse, something can air.
Today, Larry is a successful news editor that has worked on many pieces that have won numerous Emmy awards. But it was not an easy road to get to where he is today. Let's take a look at how Larry began his career.
I had always wanted to be something in film or television. That was always a dream of mine. Originally, my dream really was to direct films. I used to go to films all the time, and I decided the best trajectory for me would be to go to college. So after high school, I went to a college. I found a college that had a very good program for people in my business, and usually it was communications. It could be theater. It could be even English. I was an English major for a year.
Larry had the dream, the drive, and the degree. But without any experience, how is he going to get his first big break in this highly competitive industry? He sent out hundreds of resumes and was willing to work for no pay just to get his foot in the door. Another key word here, determination.
So I did that hundreds of times and got no response. And that kind of thing is where you really have to be wanting to be in this field, because a lot of people will get very discouraged and drop out. I was very determined to do it. And what I started doing was I started finding that the best way to get a job was networking. I would call someone and ask them, do you need anybody? And I found out that the way to start in the film business anyway was as a production assistant.
Finally, he got some responses and began working as a production assistant. As a production assistant, you learn the ropes, so to speak. You go out and get coffee, you do crowd control, you help set up cameras and other equipment, and you help the production team in other ways. Over time, Larry found out he was a really good camera operator.
Finally, I would manage to get a job at ABC Television as a cameraman, and I would work on a morning show there. And I also started doing sports, and I worked for both ABC and ESPN doing sports.
Eventually, Larry began working at different networks as a video editor. Here he is with ABC News anchor David Muir. You can work as an editor on all kinds of programs, documentaries, TV shows, music videos, and so on.
The difference between news and documentaries are great. First of all, with documentaries, usually you have a lot more time to do it. I've worked 6 months on a documentary. And that's why when you watch a documentary, it has a lot of beautiful moments and they let things breathe and there's music and there's fast-paced shots. But if you're watching a news broadcast, it's not usually like that. First of all, it's against our policy to use music unless it's for a reason. But secondly, we only have a very short time to tell a story. We have a minute 15, a minute 30, maybe 2 minutes to tell a story. If you go to a documentary, they could have an hour or an hour and a half to tell a story.
Larry loved the artistic process of working on documentaries, but he does say that there's something special about working in the newsroom.
The difference for me is, at the end of the day, with news, I can forget about what I did that day, and the next day is a whole new day with a new story.
Larry then tells us some of the personality traits that might be helpful for someone working in news editing.
To be an editor, one of the traits that you really need is a little bit of stubbornness, because you have to keep doing the same thing over and over again till it looks perfect. The other thing you have to be is you have to be pretty good under stress, because there's always some kind of time constraint where you have to finish by a certain time. You can't panic. You can't get upset. You have to just be very doggedly push ahead, move in that direction to finish the piece that you're working on.
To be an editor, you're also going to have to be creative. Don't forget, you've got an expectant audience waiting for a compelling story that you have to create for them with the script you're given.
They'll give you a script, which is words on a paper. You have to be able to read those words and imagine what you would see, what you would want to see as a viewer. And it also has to be, you know, fairly entertaining. Even though we are a news organization, we have to keep the interest going.
Behind the scenes of a newsroom can go from calm to frenetic in a split second.
With people running down a hallway with tape, although nowadays things are done by clips through computers, but sometimes we have to use tape and people will still run down hallways with tape in their hand or a script. People are screaming behind you at each other. There's lawyers involved. What surprised me most about this business was how many people are involved in this, not just you and a producer who sits there and funnels video towards you, but there's camera people, lighting people, makeup, hair. There's the set people.
And it goes on and on. Any one broadcast could have upwards of 600 people working on it. As with many jobs over the past few years, editors have started to switch from working in an office to working at home using secure logins and networks. So where do we go from here?
I could see the future being where you put on virtual reality glasses, and by swiping your hand, you can move clips from one thing to the other.
And speaking of the future, what are the potential prospects or salaries for this kind of work? Well, the job outlook for film and video editors and camera operators are all expected to grow faster than average, at 12% over the next 8 to 10 years. In the year 2021, the median annual wage for a video editor was about $63,000. As far as lines of work go, you could become a video editor for a company, like how Larry's on staff for CBS. Or you can become a freelance video editor. This means that you work for yourself and take on projects as they come to you. You finish one up, you look for another client, you finish that project. There's a lot more freedom when you go freelance, but then you don't get the health insurance or paid vacations or any of the other nice benefits that you would get if you were on staff for a company. So, what kind of advice does Larry have for anyone looking to become a video editor or to just join the broadcast industry in general?
My advice, if you really wanted to get into this business, is first of all, don't give up. You have to be really, really sure this is what you want and go for it.
You could look for an internship or just volunteer to work on set. But how do you really leave your mark and stand out from the crowd?
Try to be there before everybody else and stay until everybody else leaves. People like that. They respect it. They respect hard work. If you have an idea for something, don't be afraid to speak up. Give them your idea. No matter who you are, whether you're a production assistant or an executive producer, if you have an idea, you speak up, people will listen.
And that wraps up another career exploration video. I hope that the excellent information and advice that Larry so graciously gave us will help you pursue your career, whatever that path may be. See you next time.